Hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy Joe Plays Games, and today in the second video on the channel, we're breaking down everything that went on at Sony's PS5 PlayStation Showcase today. In the front half of the video, we got my top four moments from the conference, live reactions. There were some bangers, and then in the back half, I kind of break down what everything I thought about the conference, kind of rank it, kind of, you know, give a little of my analysis. So I hope you guys do enjoy the video. Make sure to like the video. It really does help the channel grow. Comment your thoughts on the showcase down below. Let me know what your predictions were. Let me know what your top moment of the conference was. And make sure to subscribe so you don't miss a beat of what comes next on the channel. Thank you guys so very much for watching. And enjoy the video.
Let's look at some new and amazing games.
All right, I'm in, Jim. I'm in. What you got for me? Lucas, we're starting with Lucasfilm. What is this?
Peace is a lie. That is what the Sith believe.
Is it a new Star Wars game? What?
They promise power. Now they wield.
Now you have my attention. We got some red lightsabers or pink.
Sith in generations.
No, I'm in. Is
it? Must be stopped.
It's Coder remake, let's go! Yes, baby! A legend remade for PS5. Okay, what else? Date? Or just announcement? Okay, just announcement. That's fine, but that's pretty hype. That's hype to start.
Enjoy.
Thank you, Herman. I will. All right, I'm in. Let's go. See what you got for me. What do you got for me? So what does Insomniac have?
At the dark.
No way! Are we? Oh my gosh. Are we ready already? It's DLC? What do we got? Is this Deadpool? No. No way is Deadpool. That looks like Logan. What? What do we have? This is Logan, isn't it? Oh my gosh! What? Marvel Wolverine? Oh my gosh, they're building their own universe! They're building their own universe! Let's go! Oh my gosh, you got two hypes so far out of me. Two hypes. What's next? Diner, Goodman Street, Greenwich Street. Is there anything I can recognize?
For as long as I can remember, I have looked for an equal.
Could this be infamous?
One who could.
Nope, that's Spider-Man. What do we got? What?
One who could surprise me.
Well, what is going on?
One who could even beat me. Is disappointment.
What is going on?
Will one of you finally give me what I desire?
That's Kraven, right? It's gotta be the voice. What is going on in this conference?
Yes.
That's Venom.
We will.
Yes, Spidey 2. That's confirming that it. Both are in development. What is going on? Oh my gosh. 2023, we're putting a date on it. Let's go. Yes. The other one didn't have a date on it, though. What is going on? Out of Insomniac. Insomniac is not staying on the bench. They are MJ Goat 23ing. They are staying on the floor. They want the last shot. Goodness gracious, PlayStation Studios. All right, what do you got for me now? That's three hype moments. That's three. God of War. Let's go, baby. Ragnarok time. It's supposed to be next year. How big is Atreus looking? Oh, there's the music. Look at Santa. Kinda. A little older. 2 years, maybe?
Time is running out. The prophecies say Fimbulwinter leads to Ragnarok. War is coming. My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there, finding out who I am, who Loki is.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with God.
I don't want to fight anymore.
Right,
I just want answers.
And if those answers lead to war with Asgard?
Maybe that's what Mother wanted.
You do not know what Mother wanted.
Well, I'd recognize that dour expression anywhere. Odin's got tricks up his sleeve we haven't dared to consider.
What if there was someone who could help us?
You mean Tyr, the old god of war in these lands, who is dead?
Well, for a dead man, Odin seemed pretty keen on seeing he wasn't found.
If he's out there, we gotta find him.
Come in!
What in all yarns be the have been doing?
We're trying to stop Ragnarok, to help people. And what if the only way to do that is war?
War is not the only
way. I'm game, man. I'm so game.
Stop thinking like a father for a moment and start thinking like a general.
No! You seem like a calm and reasonable person.
Is that Josh Brolin?
Are you a calm and reasonable person?
That sounded like Brolin. I could be tripping, but... No, I'm so ready for this game, man. It took me forever to get on the end of the last one.
Crisis. Panic does nothing.
I'm in now.
What is it? Let it serve you.
Tyr!
Are you coming with us?
Let's go. I am so game. God of War Ragnarok, baby.
You'll get your answers soon enough. Well, some of them.
Is that... Yo, now that you just finished looking at the highlights of my reactions to the PlayStation press conference, let's get into my kind of thoughts about it. I've pulled up some articles here in the background that we're going to go through. It's just two articles. It's going to be from the PlayStation blog. One from Insomniac and one from Sony Santa Monica. And I mean, that's kind of really all we need to discuss on that front. Obviously, I could go look up the big banger reveal at the beginning from KOTOR being remade, not remastered like the Alan Wake and the Uncharted games which are being remastered. This is a full ground up remake. I saw in my searching in between the finishing of the press conference that some of the old people that were originally on the original are going to be returning to the new studio that is developing it. There was no date on that, so I'm excited. I would expect that to be 2023-2024 type for release. But regardless, I'm excited. That was a really good way to start off the conference. There was some cool... Obviously, I was excited for Deathloop. And there was a couple other small things in between in the third-party side of the conference that I was excited for. But I wasn't like, oh my gosh, blown away. Then we hit the PlayStation exclusive side, and that's when, you know, things start to get real busy. Obviously, I went two for four because we got something from God of War Ragnarok. Nothing from Bluepoint, nothing from Last of Us Factions. Really kind of shocked about Factions. Bluepoint's kind of hit or miss. It recently, I think the acquiring of Bluepoint's been kind of secretive, kind of. They're not really talking about it. But then we got the big tease with Spider-Man 2. It was like 20, 30 second tease. But it was there. So I technically went 2 for 4. And Spidey, I definitely didn't really believe in that prediction. So that's kind of crazy. But I want to kind of talk about it. Because obviously next year we're getting Horizon Forbidden West early in March. God of War is shaping up to look like it's probably going to be a holiday release. Around October time. And then it's the... That's next year, 2022. Spider-Man 2 had a 2023 release date on it. I question if that's hitting that date. But that could be a June release date, and they could be shifting teams around, obviously, because Ratchet got put out, let's see, 4 months ago-ish? 5 months ago? No. Four to three months ago. So anyone who's on that team probably took a little break and then reshifted. And that team is probably being split up, kind of, because I know they got studios in Raleigh and California. So some of that, I think the Raleigh team is probably the team that's working on Wolverine. Small portion, and then that's been whoever was working on Ratchet. Once that was done, all the updates, there's probably a small team keeping it updated, fixing bugs and stuff. But then the rest of that team is being pushed over to the Wolverine project. And then the team out in California, which put out Miles last year in 2020, is now going to have a full 3 years to finish development on this. And I imagine it has been developed since 2018 when the original Spider-Man was released. It's kind of been in the background. I would imagine both projects were kind of being developed at the same time, because you don't have to, they didn't recreate the map or anything. All they did was reskin and do some new abilities. So the game was shorter. So I'd imagine there's a chance that 2023 release date is real year wise. It's probably toward the back end of the year though, in my opinion. And the Wolverine game, I'd put 2024, maybe 2023 if we're really lucky. But I'd feel like that's probably 2024 release. With Last of Us Factions, my guess would be coming in 2020. If we're sticking to the theory, God of War Ragnarok is ready to not. It's obviously not ready to go. It's not gone gold. There's no date attached to it. But if we're sticking to the idea that we got March for Horizon, or that's what the guests make, because I don't think there's an actual date, then we're gonna get God of War, and that's either gonna be a July summer game, and it's gonna hit big, or I believe they hold it till end of the year, and that they could pair it with Last of Us Factions if that is ready. If it's not ready, they're not going to do anything with it. But I feel like Last of Us Factions could be kind of a similar situation to Spider-Man Miles Morales, where it was announced within 6 months of release. So that you're in an interesting situation with that, because of the multiplayer element to it. You have a big studio behind it, but it's also, because it's multiplayer, it can kind of just be put out whenever there is a hole. So I think Last of Us Factions is kind of going to flow in between where Spider-Man 2 and God of War Ragnarok are, because those are the only, we've got nothing past that that's Sony Studios. Obviously, Naughty Dog is working on something, Blue Point's working on something, Ben's working on something, and there's multiple teams now. A lot of those studios have grown to have two or three teams, as well as the new acquisitions they've hired. So that 2023-2024 space is going to fill out gradually, probably next year, over whether it be Summer Games Fest, more State of Plays / actual big PlayStation conference style events like the one we just finished watching. But I think that's putting, as I said in my reaction, Insomniac has not sat down on the bench. They're going to keep firing, and I think they're going to overtake Naughty Dog as worldwide top studio. Because that trailer for Wolverine looked heat, and I imagine Spider-Man 2 is going to be great. So I'm very, very excited. I want to break down this one little piece of the Spider-Man press blog from Insomniac Studios. They talk about Tony Todd of Candyman fame will be voicing Venom. They're going to talk about suits and abilities eventually, later on down the line. I feel like after God of War Ragnarok comes out, this game kind of hits front and center. Because God of War Ragnarok was kind of the bigger thing that's been hiding behind Horizon. And when it was originally announced, it was just that thing. We've seen absolutely nothing since then. And we've had Ratchet be released. And Ratchet didn't, in my mind, it obviously had events where it was shown, but it wasn't like this huge, massive blowout. You're going to get that, I think, for Ragnarok. You're going to see it probably 1 to 2 more times, and they're gonna have another State of Play, I would bet, around the release of Horizon, and then you'll get another look at Ragnarok then, and then a Ragnarok exclusive State of Play, where then you'll get possibly a hint at Last of Us Factions. And then we go into Wolverine. They talk about their history with the project and that they've been excited for it, and ever since they pitched Spider-Man, them and the people over at Marvel kind of been excited about it. Brian Horton, creative director. Cameron Christian is game director, who recently led... they were part of the team of Miles Morales, a game that they're super proud of. But there's an important point right here. Even though Marvel's Wolverine is very early in development, from what I've seen of its emotional narrative and cutting-edge gameplay... See what I did there? Little puns, dad puns. The team's already creating something truly special, so I'm excited just based solely off that. But obviously, it's a game studio talking about its own game, so it's going to be very exciting. But there was a part I missed. Marvel's Wolverine is a standalone game. That's the thing I want to talk about just really quickly. That's very interesting to me, because my initial reaction when that was shown in the press conference was to think that they're slowly building toward a larger Marvel universe, Marvel Insomniac universe of sorts. But the fact that it's a standalone game makes me think that you're going to get... It's possible to go from Marvel's Wolverine to Marvel's X-Men from Insomniac. I mean, it's also possible that you do a Marvel's Spider-Man and Wolverine crossover game, because they've done that many times in the comics. But that's just an interesting... Whatever. It's just an interesting thing to think about. Keep in mind when we think about this game. I am absolutely just a massive fan of that. And then let's look at the God of War Ragnarok Sony Santa Monica press release as well, just really quickly. Talk about the events. Talk about the down here main antagonist, kind of the basic story. Nine realms will be able to... You'll be able to travel all nine realms you couldn't in the first game. You've got antagonists being Frey and Thor. Frey because of the first game. Thor also because of the first game. You got magic on one side and bloodlust on the other. So that's that story, or storyline component. The axe. With God of War Ragnarok, one of our main goals is to push player choice in combat. So they're gonna mass that out. They're gonna grow it out, and then see you next year. I think I just saw something on Twitter before I started this part of this. It says next installment in the series will bring you a more diverse, beautiful. There's okay. So happy to finally see. Oh, obviously I'm absolutely blind. See you next year. So they're hoping to stick to that next year release date. Talked about Tyr. I think Tyr was from the original game too. That he was just kind of talked about a lot. Let's see, here, hold on. We're gonna see if I can find this really quick. Here, God of War Ragnarok will bring the Norse saga to an epic end. I think there's a chance that there's a third game. I don't think you're gonna do just two, unless that's the new thing at Sony. They're gonna do Last of Us 1, Last of Us 2, not do 3, and then you'll do God of War, and then God of War Ragnarok, and that'll be it. I think trilogies really kind of work better. I want to go here and just, you know, look at that picture. Just look at that man's beautiful claws. I think this press conference was really solid. Obviously, you're not going to have something for everybody in there, but I think there was enough variety from third party and then a lot of heavy hitters from first party and some good announcements from third party. Because that sounded like that Coda remake is exclusive to PS5, or at least partially exclusive. So I'm excited for what's to come next. Let me know if you want me to do kind of a breakdown in the comments on more Wolverine and Spider-Man stuff. Any predictions for that? But we're a really long way out, and it's shaping up to be probably Gotham Knights in between probably Horizon and God of War. And then you're shaping up to have, in between God of War and Spider-Man 2, to be Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League, kind of around there. So we're setting up some really great superhero games. Obviously, we have Guardians of the Galaxy this fall, which had a good showing in the showcase. So thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like the video, please. It really does help the channel. Comment your thoughts down below on the press conference. And subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a beat of our nerd coverage. I'm not sure the plan for the video tomorrow. We'll see. See if you have any ideas. I may do a Titans video or a Marvel's What If. Just kind of catching up on the series so far and my opinions. Or we may do a podcast. We'll see. Tomorrow's Friday. So we we may have some fun times. But thank you guys very much for watching, and peace.